Good morning. It's Tuesday, April 23rd, 2013, coming up to 8:30 a.m. on the East Coast. And stock index futures are now above fair value. We're seeing a nice pop in the futures. Dow futures currently up about 50 points on some earnings in the pre-market this morning. Not a lot of trend changes to talk about this morning. Let's start off by looking at some overseas trading. The Xetra DAX is up this morning. It's currently up about 100 points, and we're watching closely to see if it can hold the 7,500 level. If you look above where we are now, you see that we had a lot of support there in February, and we've broken through that support. So now that support is going to be resistance on the way back up. If we're able to trade above those lows, then you can see here, right along this line, we've got a lot of resistance there that was previously support. So we may see a move up to that level and then start to come back down from there. Looking at what happened in Asia overnight, we saw some selling in Hong Kong. Did not close below the lower channel line, but we certainly did in Shanghai. So we're back on a sell signal for the internal Chinese market. And looking at the Nikkei, still holding highs. The yen is still holding down at the lows, and so no change in trend in Japan. Next up, let's take a look at some pieces of the puzzle, starting with bonds. Bonds were basically unchanged yesterday. Still looking for money to come out of the bonds to prop up the overall stock market. Obviously, the indexes can do pretty good when people are chasing the dividend-paying stocks. But for the overall stock market to rise, we're looking for money to come out of bonds. And, of course, we're looking for a sell signal in the VIX. And so we're looking for a close below 1383 for the S&P 500 VIX and below 1333 for the NASDAQ 100 VIX. And we're pretty close to getting that right now. Looking at the major indexes, we traded back in the channel for the S&P 500. Traded up towards the upper channel line yesterday for the NASDAQ 100. Need to close above 28,2093 to get that on Tuesday. And of course, all eyes will be focused on Apple Computer, which reports after hours on Tuesday. The Russell moved up to the lower channel line. The Zacks moved back in the channel. Lower channel line for bank stocks. Lower channel line for energy stocks. Nothing going on with gold and silver stocks. Chip stocks moved up into the channel, and seeing a lot of strength in the transports right now, with a lot of leadership coming from the railroad stocks. Next up, let's take a look at my five stocks. Apple Computer, no change there. Of course, Apple reports after hours tonight. The CME Group is back on a buy signal as of Monday's close. We took half our money off the table on a short position at 59.38. We were looking to take another half off at 57.81. That did not happen, so we need to buy back our short position this morning and go long at the open. Taking a look at Google, still on a buy signal, no change there. No change for Goldman Sachs and no change for Visa. Yesterday, we looked at Caterpillar, which had reported in the pre-market and apparently disappointed in the pre-market. But once the stock got trading, it actually moved up with the rest of the market yesterday and traded back in the channel. A close above 83.86 would give us a new buy signal on Tuesday. Looking at the world of commodities, no trend changes on Monday. We saw copper hit a two-year low yesterday. And of course, if copper is heading lower, that's not a good sign for the global economy. Gold moved up to the lower channel line yesterday. Silver had an inside day. Little strength in crude oil on both sides of the ocean, whether in Europe or in the U.S. Looking at gasoline, no change there. No change for heating oil and no trend change for natural gas. We did pull back to the upper channel line. Last up this morning, quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. Still projecting lower prices here for the VIX. Of course, as long as we stay above 1534, we should expect higher prices for the U.S. stock market on Tuesday. For the S&P 500, still projecting higher prices here. We were looking for a move up to 1562.50 yesterday as our first target. We hit that and basically closed at it. Today, our next target to the upside is 1570.31. On the downside, we'll remain bullish on the U.S. stock market as long as we don't start closing below 1553.81 on an hourly basis. And looking at the NASDAQ, we're looking for a move up to the bottom of the open gap as our first stopping point. We got that yesterday, and now we're looking for a move up to the top of the open gap, and that's just above our mathematical target of 28.3203 for the NASDAQ 100. And on the downside, we'll remain bullish on the NASDAQ 100 on Tuesday as long as we don't start closing below 27.8851. Okay, folks, looking at the futures, they've moved a bit higher. Dow futures currently up about 70 points. So we are looking for some buying at the open on Tuesday morning. Have a great day, and I'll talk to you again next on Wednesday morning.